In this video, we explore the Multipress functionality and the Websend command to control a different Tasmota device. And then we go one step further using Websend to control WLED devices without MQTT or Home Assistant. As we have seen before, there are switch modes for momentary buttons, so you can use a button and select switch in configuration. But there is also a button option there. As we can see in the documentation, Tasmota has support for multi-press functions for buttons. That means you can use a momentary button for 6 different actions: single, double, triple, quad, penta, and hold for long presses. And every button state is represented by a number, so we can easily create rules using them. A little warning before we continue. When you define a pin as a button, that is button 1, and automatically is controlling the relay in the board if there is one. We use a T1 mini with a relay and a momentary button for this video. Other boards, like the Son of SV you used in the previous video, already has a small button attached, which is by default button number 1 for Tasmota, even though that is not obvious in the web interface. As you cannot change the pins for the onboard relay or button, you don't see them in the configuration module. If you add an external button, that must be defined as button number 2. First of all, we set the button and the relay for our T1 mini and then we test it. If you select to use multi-press function, you must detach the button from the relay. For this we use set option 73, so we type SO73 in the console. Now, when we press the button, nothing happens, but we can see in the console the actions of the button as single, double, and so on. This is not convenient, so we create a rule to toggle our relay when we press the button once. We use number 10 as button state for single press. Then we create a second rule to toggle the relay of the Son of Basic when we press the button twice. We use number 11 as a button state for double press. In this case, we use Websend. Websend sends a command over HTTP, using the IP of the second device. Of course, using fixed IPs for these devices in your network is a requirement, so the rule keeps working in the future. WSend is very useful in a network of many Tasmota devices, even if you use an MQTT server, as it will work even if your server is down or restarting. But what for other devices like WLED I also love? For this I should use MQTT, right? This is what I thought too, but I knew WLED has an HTTP API and I was wondering how hard it would be to call it from Websend. Actually, it's not that hard at all. So we take a look in the WLED HTTP API documentation and write down the commands we are interested in. Here we use the commands to toggle power and call a preset. I use my two WLED lamps, which are synced, so I only need to send the command to the master. So I create a rule using a triple press that sends a command to toggle the power. And then do a second test, applying preset number 6.